Hi everyone, my name is Zia Maliki. Today I'm going to show you how to take a screenshot on Windows 10. Let's jump right into it. Here I am on the desktop. We need something to take a screenshot of. What about taking a screenshot of my YouTube page? So here is my YouTube channel's homepage. We are going to take a screenshot of this today. I'm going to show you two different methods to take a screenshot. One is by using an app that comes with Windows 10. And the second technique is using your keyboard. So let's start with the app that comes with Windows 10. The easiest way you can get into it is to open up the search box and type in Snipping Tool. That's the name of the app, Snipping Tool. I'm gonna go ahead and type it in, and there you see it right there. The other way you can get to it is by clicking the start menu, and this is a long way to get to it. Go to a start menu and scroll into the very bottom down here. Alphabetically, we will go to the edge section, and here we can see the Snipping Tool app. If you want an easier access to this app in the future, you can pin that to the start menu. It will show up where all these apps are. I can also right click on it and pin it to the taskbar. I will pin it to the taskbar because it's the tool that I use quite often. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to click on it from the taskbar to open up the Snipping Tool. Now there are few different modes that the Snipping Tool has. You can do a full screen capture. With that, it takes a screenshot of the entire desktop. There is also Windows Snip, and I will show you how that works. Here I can click on the window that I want to take a screenshot of, or I can take a screenshot of the whole desktop. There is also rectangular snip and freeform snip. With rectangular snip, I can simply highlight an area that I want to take a screenshot of. And the other option, which is the freeform, and here I'm going to do my best to make a circle of this area, and there you have it. Here is a screenshot of the area I selected. What I can do is, I can go to the file and I can save this as different file types. I have the option to save it as PNG, GIF, or JPG. So I can choose what type of file I want to save it. PNG is the default. I can also email it to someone from here as well. What I can also do with this tool is I can annotate. So here is a pen tool. Let's say that I want to point out to this section. I can highlight this area with a yellow color. So here you can do some highlighting and stuff as well if you want to. I can also go ahead and erase if I don't like any highlighted area. What you can also do is that you can set up delay. It is similar to taking a photo of your family, where someone wants to hit the take photo button and then everyone runs together for the picture. So here is one way you can delay the screenshot. This is what the Snipping Tool is all about. Very useful tool if you want to take a screenshot. Okay, so now that we had a look at the Snipping Tool, what I want to do next is that I want to show you how you can take a screenshot using your keyboard. There are a few different keyboard shortcuts depending on the type of keyboard you have. So the way you print your screen is going to be a little different. So if you look at the top row of your keyboard, there is a button called Print Screen. Simply press the function and print screen buttons at the same time. And there it looks like the screenshot was taken. Now I need to paste it somewhere. We can paste it in the Paint program, Word program, or any other relevant program. Let's open up the Paint program and paste it there. From here, we can save it to any location we want. Now I will go to that location, and here is the print screen I just did. So the print screen captures the entire screen. Let's say I want to select this window and just want to take a screenshot of this window. What I can do is just press the function and Alt key together with the print screen button. So now I can go and paste it in the paint program and save it in a location of my choice. Now I can go to that location where I saved the screenshot, and here is the screenshot of the window I just took. Even if my desktop is bigger than that window, I can limit the screenshot just to that window. But another great technique is, if you press the function in Windows key together with the print screen button, it will automatically save a copy of the screenshot in the picture folder. Let's try that as well. I'm pressing the function in Windows key together with the print screen button. Now you go to this PC, pictures, and then screenshots, and there you can see the screenshot I just took. Today I showed you two different ways you can take a screenshot. One of them is with the Snipping Tool app. The other is using your keyboard and hitting the print screen button, combining with the function key. Hope this video has increased your knowledge of how to take a screenshot. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, because I love seeing thumbs up on my video. If you want to see future tech videos like this, then hit that subscribe button. And that way you will get a notification anytime I publish new content. Well, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.